Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh, and this is your stimulus check update for the next stimulus package for Saturday, October 3rd. I hope everyone is off to a good and safe start to their Saturday so far. In this video, I'll be discussing both the first and second stimulus check. I'll also be discussing unemployment, the recent negotiations between Nancy Pelosi and Steven Mnuchin, and then I'll be wrapping up this video by answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. But first, if you wouldn't mind real quickly liking this video, giving me a big thumbs up, it really just helps with the YouTube algorithm in terms of pushing this video out to other viewers like you, and hopefully helping other people like you as well. Okay, so a lot of news to get into today, but first I'm going to give a quick update on the federal unemployment insurance benefits. We still have just 6 states who haven't started paying out benefits yet, which include the states that you see up on the screen. Now, we should see all 6 of these states pay out over the course of October, and by the time this month ends, we can also hope that Congress can finally reach a bipartisan agreement to extend these benefits even longer. Since the recent federal unemployment extension from FEMA only included payments to those who earned at least $100 weekly from state unemployment insurance benefits, there were a lot of people who ended up not getting anything. Also, even though the unemployment rate continues to drop, with the unemployment rate falling another 0.5% all the way down to 7.9%, we still have a long ways to go to get back to pre-pandemic unemployment levels. Much expectedly, progress in the unemployment department has been slowing down, so we may need to bridge the gap for a few more months to get back to normalcy. Let's hope for the best in that regard. And stimulus-related news. Nancy Pelosi just announced that airlines will receive more relief through a standalone bill if broader stimulus talks fall apart. Pelosi said, quote, "The massive furloughs and firings of America's airline workers jeopardize the livelihoods of tens of thousands and threaten to accelerate the devastating economic crisis facing our nation. Today, I am calling upon the airlines to delay their devastating job cuts as relief for airline workers is being advanced in Congress." Okay, so more relief for airlines is worthy of a standalone bill, but more relief for Americans in the form of stimulus checks and other aid isn't? Gotcha. I guess we know where Congress stands on that one, or at least where Nancy Pelosi stands. Now, I'm generally in favor of this. A standalone bill for the airlines is a fantastic thing. I'm not a huge fan of bailouts in general, but if it's going to save thousands of people from being laid off and allow people and their families to continue to receiving paychecks on a weekly basis, I'm all for it. However, if you're going to pass a standalone bill for airlines, which I'm for, then you better also pass numerous other standalone bills as well. Pelosi said the massive furloughs and firings of America's airline workers jeopardize the livelihoods of tens of thousands of people. Well, guess how many thousands of people are having their lives also jeopardized by not receiving more aid? The American people you serve. So, not much to say about that one, but I also can't say we should be all that surprised. In other stimulus-related news, Nancy Pelosi had more to say about the upcoming relief package and negotiations going on with the Trump administration. In a statement, she said that she does anticipate striking a bipartisan economic relief deal with the Trump administration, suggesting that President Trump's virus diagnosis could possibly speed up an agreement. Pelosi said that this kind of changes the dynamic because here they see what the reality we have been saying all along. This is a vicious virus. Pelosi went on to say that she's optimistic, but they always have to find a path, that it's their responsibility to do so, and she believes that they will. White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows told reporters that even after President Trump tested positive for the virus, he's been inquiring about the status of the relief package talks. It seems that Trump is still pushing heavily for Mnuchin to get something done, but it's doubtful Mnuchin will go up much higher than the $1.6 trillion at this point. He's already mentioned that he won't go above $2 trillion, and even if he does, there's no way you would get enough Republicans on board to approve it. But still, even with the two sides only being $600 billion apart, they're not all that far off. Nancy Pelosi could either decide to bring her number down to $1.6 trillion and call it a deal, or the two sides could decide to meet in the middle once again at $1.9 trillion. However, at $1.9 trillion, it may be a tough sell to other Republicans in the Senate. Even at $1.6 trillion, it will be tough to get enough Republicans on board, but at $1.9 trillion, you're then likely going to be losing all of them. Now, there are some conservatives, including a sizable minority of Republicans in the Senate, who argue that Congress has already spent more than enough money and no more action should take place in light of the ballooning budget deficit. Also, leaders from the conservative groups R Street, Libre Initiative, Heritage Action, and Americans for Prosperity joined a conference call urging lawmakers to reject any agreement made. These groups see the near $27 trillion in national debt this country has and fully realize that it's going to be a tough hill to climb out of to get out of this debt. Still though, another round of stimulus will only help President Trump's poll numbers, so you better bet that he's pushing hard for the administration to strike a deal just before Election Day. We're also seeing a whole lot of urgency among some of the more moderate Democrats in the House. In the stimulus bill Democrats passed on Thursday, 17 Democrats voted against it, which is three more than the disapprovals from the original HEROES Act they passed way back in May. Most of the more moderate Democrats in the House seemed generally unhappy that they were voting on a partisan bill to send a message to other Republicans rather than an actual bipartisan bill. It was pointless, essentially. It showed their seriousness, sure, but it had no chance of actually passing the Senate in its current form. Now, it has been noted recently that Steven Mnuchin called other GOP senators, letting them know that he's going to agree to more money for state and local government, which has been a sticking point in negotiations with Pelosi. The reason for calling them, of course, was to soften the blow when news came out that the deal ended up getting even closer to $2 trillion. So, all in all, it does sound like Pelosi and Mnuchin are going to end up reaching a deal after all, which will at least give us a shot at getting a bill passed through both chambers. We will also have to wait and see if Nancy Pelosi and other Democrats are willing to lower the weekly federal unemployment benefits down to around the $400 per week mark. If Mnuchin raises the amount given for state and local governments, and Pelosi lowers her amount for unemployment, then we may just have a deal. The only question will be at that point is if Mitch McConnell will also get on board with that plan, and if he does, will he be able to convince enough Republicans in the Senate to also approve of the plan as well? Time will only tell, but I can't remember a time where the two sides were this close to reaching a deal. Things are looking very good right now, and I'm very optimistic they'll be reaching a deal at some point next week. As always though, we've been in this situation before, where the two sides were close to reaching an agreement on something, and then everything fell apart. So in the meantime, let's just continue to prepare for the worst, but hope for the best. With that said, I am feeling pretty good about a deal taking place very, very soon. Okay, so at this point, I'm just going to move right along to some quick updates on the first round of stimulus payments, because unfortunately, even though most people have already received their first stimulus check, there are still millions of people who are still waiting for it. With that said, let me know in the comment section below if you've received your first stimulus check or if you're still currently waiting for it. As mentioned in previous videos, if you still haven't received your first check, more than likely it's because you were either claimed as a dependent on someone's recent tax return or you haven't filed a tax return within the last 2 years. So if you're not on Social Security benefits and you haven't filed a tax return within the last 2 years, then you should go ahead and quickly fill out the non-filers tool by October 15th in order to receive your payment this year. Otherwise, unfortunately, you may end up having to claim a $1,200 credit on next year's tax returns in order to receive your money. For all the others who are still waiting, in the meantime, I would just recommend to continue checking the payment portal as that will be your number one resource. Now, if you would like to reach out to the IRS and talk to a live human instead, you can still most definitely do that by calling them at 1-800-919-9835. And the only recommendation that I would have for you is to call just a little bit earlier in the day just to avoid those longer hold times. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video by answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. And if you do have any other questions for me, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I do try to answer as many of the comments and questions as I possibly can, but for those comments and questions I'm not able to respond to, I do try to pick some of the more popular ones to answer in the next video in video form. Okay, so without further ado, let me go ahead and jump into the first comment of today's video, which is from Monica. Monica says, because of this election coming up so soon, does that mean it might take longer for there to be a decision on getting a second stimulus check? Or do you think they'll come to a decision to sway our votes? I love your YouTube channel. Thanks for all the information you provide for us. Okay, thank you so much for your question, Monica, and I also appreciate for you tuning in. More than likely, I think it has more to do with the latter of wanting to get something done to sway our votes. Many Democrats and Republicans alike are facing re-election in the House and the Senate, so they need to look like they're doing their very best to get something done. Some of the more moderate Democrats, for example, have been pressuring Nancy Pelosi for weeks now to get a more bipartisan bill passed through the House once again. So I do believe the increased pressure to get something done just before the election is definitely playing a role here. Okay, moving right along to the next question of today's video, which is from Dark Angel. Dark Angel says, my cousin is on SSID, and if they do a $2,000 per month stimulus, will he still get his SSID? Okay, thank you so much for your question. And yes, anyone on Social Security benefits will still receive their normal benefits on top of any stimulus checks that are issued. So whether you're on Social Security survivors, retirement, or disability, you'll still receive your normal benefits check on top of whatever you receive as far as the next stimulus check goes as well. Alright, so on that note, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. If you did enjoy the content in this video and you'd like to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It is completely free to do so and it's a great support to me. Also, if you'd like to receive one free stock from Webull, valued all the way up to $1,600, please feel free to claim that free stock by clicking the link in the description box below. And until next time, I'll see you guys and I hope you have a great day today.